Very good morning, all the students. Today we will see the very important structural part of a building, that is called shear wall. So this is a part of this is a theoretical part which will be asked in your examinations for about 7 marks about the shear wall and its various types and its design procedures. So today we will focus on the introduction of shear wall, its various types and the design procedure as per the relevant IS 456 and 13920 codes. Okay, so I have prepared this PPT with the reference of the Handbook of Concrete Engineering by Lintel and Advanced Reinforced Concrete Design by PC Varghese. So whatever the content we will cover in this lecture, these are all the parts of a reference. Okay, so let us start with the shear wall. So basically, introduction: a shear wall is nothing but a wall which is a concrete wall specially designed in the building to resist the lateral forces. The important part here in this case is to resist the lateral force. Why we are interested in the shear wall? Because we are dealing with the earthquake forces, and also already we know that the earthquake forces are predominant on the building structures in the form of a horizontal forces, and these horizontal forces, when act on a particular joint on the building, it will allow the building to sway in either rightward and leftward directions because of the earthquake effect. Okay, so basically shear walls are the walls which are basically designs and specially designed to resist the lateral forces, and that are produced in a plane of a wall due to the wind and earthquake forces. Okay, then next is the shear walls are generally provided in the tall buildings, okay, and to avoid the total collapse of the building under the lateral forces. They are usually provided between the columns and the stair walls, lift well, and toilet and utility shaft. So if you see the lift block, okay, if you see the lift block in a general building, the lift block is basically built up by using a reinforced cement concrete wall, and that are equally treated as a shear wall. Okay, now next is important properties of shear wall. So there are various properties. First of all, the good ductility, because the structure have to be a good ductile in order to resist the lateral forces. Okay, so the good ductility play a very important role under the reversible and repeated overloads. Okay, then the second one is a less bending tensile stress due to the lateral loads than located the symmetrical to avoid the torsional stresses. So as we know that as the building is tall, that is more than 40 meters in height as per the codal provision of IS 1893, so the dynamic analysis is compulsory. So in that case, if you see the configuration of the building from the top, and if the building is a unsymmetrical building, then the effect of torsional is very, very high in the building. So in that case also, the shear wall play a very important role to resist the torsional effect or the torsional stresses develop in the building. Then the most important part is the stiffness. So the stiffness of the shear wall is very, very high in its own plane. So because of the high stiffness, it resists the lateral forces. This is also a very important point. Then next is the typical arrangement of a shear wall in the building. So this is some of the examples, okay, by which you can see that the shear wall can be provided in various areas as per the structural configurations. Okay, so first of all, if you see the figure number 1, so the shear walls are provided at the corners. Second case, this is provided at the one corner, okay, and third one is a symmetrical, okay, So likewise, according to the suitability structural configuration, you can provide the shear wall in the buildings. Okay, so this is a typical plan of the building. Okay, the dotted point is represented the columns. Okay, and the bold line is represented the shear walls. Then next is, there is no limitation concern to the geometrical shape of the shear wall system. So it may be constructed or built in a triangular, rectangular, angle, channel, and wide flange, etc. are more common types of the shear walls of a geometrical forms. Then type of shear walls. This is also a very, very important theory questions which is always asked in your examinations, that what are the types of shear wall. Give some examples with suitable diagrams. So first of all, if the first is a very simple rectangular shear wall, then flange type of shear wall, then frame type of shear wall with and without infill walls, okay, then couple shear wall and column supported shear walls and core type shear wall. So these are the some of the type of the shear wall as per the type of the suitability it is provided. Okay, so these are the types. Then these are the some of the figure by which you can easily identify the various types. The first is a simple shear wall like this, simple rectangular type of shear wall. Then second one is a flange type of shear wall. This is a flange section and under which between this the shear wall is provided. Then coupled shear wall, this is a one type of shear wall having a opening is there. Then a column supported shear wall, this is also one type of example. Then core shear wall, this is a plan, an outer periphery is provided by the shear wall. Then the next part is behavior of shear wall under the lateral load conditions. Okay, so before going to the design part, one should understand that how actually the shear wall behaves under the lateral loads. So this is the analytical part, you must understand this. Okay, so it is assumed that the floor are infinitely stiff in their plane and do not deforms, and deformation of the frame is in shear modes. So the deformation of the shear wall is in the bending mode rather than a shear mode. So this is a typical deformation shape like this. The building will deform like this. Okay, this deformation shape of a shear wall under the lateral load. Okay, then the deformation shape of a frame, and the frame is deformed like this. Okay, so the pattern of deformation is different in case of shear wall than frame and shear wall deformation. This is the typical deformation of the frame and shear wall. Okay, then this is a typical analysis has been done on the software called ANSYS, and by the as a final output we can obtain the behavior of the shear wall under the lateral loads. So shear wall is nothing but a vertical system cantilever from the ground, and a brace frame like trusses wall act like a deep beam. So building that carry the gravity loads using the bearing walls typically also used as a shear wall, and the wall must designed to serve both the duties. So this is the some typical load combo has been taken. First of all, if you see that the lateral loads is considered in the first diagram, then second the gravity load is considered, and in third case the combination of both are taken. So by the virtue of which we can obtain the result like the lateral load induce the two types of motion, tipping and sliding. So as a result we will get the motion of the wall in the form of tipping and sliding. So tipping is nothing but a rotation, and sliding is nothing but a related to translation. So vertical reaction counteract tipping, and the reaction form a moment and resisting the rotation. Note the downward tension reaction, and the gravity load is counter tipping. So wall can be viewed as a pre-stress beam, and the pre-stressing effect of the gravity is generally beneficial, and they combine the compression of the gravity plus overturning can be very high, and the lateral force create a overturning moment, and while the gravity load create the resisting moment. So in this case as a result we will see that the lateral load will be responsible for the overturning moment, whereas the gravity load will be responsible for the resisting moment. Okay, so to avoid the uplift forces on the foundation, the resisting moments might be larger than the overturning moment. So this is the most important key point that you must understand, that while designing the shear force, that the resisting moment must be greater than overturning moment. so that the factor of safety will be safe. Then the resisting moment typically account only for the dead loads, and the horizontal reactions counteract sliding, and the sum of the reactions for the wall are called as a wall base shear. Okay, so this is a typical result which is obtained from the software called ANSYS, and the behavior of the wall you can see clearly in the diagram, and this is a plain XK value. So this represent the various stress level, okay, in the different color you can see that. Okay, so based on that we can see that gravity increases the compression stresses and reduces the tensile stresses, whereas for the gravity lateral acting together and distributing of the stresses is asymmetric, with most of the wall acting on the in the compression, and the compressive effect of the gravity increases the compression and decreases the tension effect. So this is a particular example if you apply the lateral loads only. Okay, so the stress increases moving downwards towards the wall. So if you see that like that, then we will see the different types of walls. Okay, the first is based on their geometrical shape. The first is the simple rectangular and barbell type of free standing shear wall. So this is a simple rectangular wall and this is a barbell type. So what are the features like, we will see that it is subjected to bending and shear under the action of vertical and horizontal forces, and the barbell type wall is nothing but it is having the minimum steel which is put over the inner face of about 0.7 to 0.8% of length. Okay, and remaining steel is placed at the end length of 0.15 to 0.12 on either side of the wall, and these are stronger and more ductile than the simple rectangular wall. So rather than preferring to the simple rectangular wall, we can go for the bar bend type of wall. Okay, so like this we can apply this, and then disadvantage is during the an earthquake effect, the dissipate a lot of energy by cracking, it is difficult to repair this type of wall. Okay, so this is the one major disadvantage. Then next is a couple shear wall. So what are the features, like let us see that. So two structural walls, if you join together by relatively a short spandrel beam, this is a spandrel beam, like a spandrel beam, if you join these two wall by using some device or some spandrel beam, then it is a connected member to form a couple shear wall, into increase the stiffness of the wall and structure dissipate the energy by yielding to the coupling beam. Then the wall should satisfy the following requirements. The system should develop the hinge only in the coupling beam before the shear failure, and the coupling beam should be designed to have a good energy dissipation characteristic. Okay, so these are the some of the characteristic of the couple shear wall. Then this is a typical formula by which you can calculate the total reactions acting on the wall. So this is some of the numerical part, so we can skip this part, we are only interested in the theory, so you can go for the theory. Okay, so next is this is a diagonal steel part. Okay, so diagonal steel is provided as shown in figure number 2, because even a large amount of transfer steel for the ductility is not effective. Okay, so we can provide the diagonal steel. As the diagonal stresses are induced because of the lateral force, so in order to resist these diagonal forces, we can provide the steel in the diagonal pattern also, in the particular shear wall. Then these are all based on the IS 13920-1993. If you go for this code and if you see, these all detailings are available. Then the next type is a rigid frame with shear wall. So as shown on in figure number 3, if you see that, so it is nothing but it is an interaction of a simple shear wall and a rigid frame of a tall building. So in shear mode, the frame and wall will deflect in bending. So it will be subjected to bending. Okay, then the interaction reduce the maximum amount, but maximum moment, but the maximum shear increase. So which will increase the tendency of the shear failure like this. Okay, then frame shear wall and infill shear wall. So let us see what are the important properties of this. So frame walls are casted monolithically, whereas the infill walls are constructed by casting the frame first and then infilling it with the masonry or the concrete block later. Then column supported shear wall. So this type of wall are constructed when shear wall are to be discontinued at the floor level. So this is a column supported. Then core type, So in some of the building, to withstand lateral loads, the vertical core is to be provided, and this can be sometimes elevators and other devices areas, and this type have a good resistance against the torsion. Okay, this is a torsion. Then classification according to the behavior. Shear wall, in which the deflection and strength are controlled by shear, these are usually the low rise walls. Then ordinary moment walls, so these are the walls in which the deflection and strength are controlled by the flexure. So these are high rise shear walls. Then ductile moment shear wall, so these are the special type of wall which are meant for the seismic region. So we can also classify the walls based on the behavior pattern. Okay, then these are the load on the shear wall. Okay, so basically this is a numerical parts, or you can say that it is a steps which are required for the numericals on the design of shear wall. So we will see this shear wall or the numerical steps in our next lecture. Okay, because in this slide it is not clear the various parameter which is considered from the relevant code. So first of all, we will go through IS 13920 1993 in detail about the various requirement of shear wall, and then we will switch to the design steps of the shear wall. Okay, so we will see the various shear wall types of shear walls, this design procedure, and various design requirement as per the relevant code first, and then we will go for the numerical procedure. Okay, so we will see this in our next lecture. Okay, so thank you very much for your kind attention. Thank you.